Welcome to the Wild Side. It's another wonderful week, and I'm with another wonderful organization. I'm here in Port Aransas, Texas, which is just southeast of Corpus Christi, about 45 minutes on the Gulf Coast of Texas. And this amazing organization helps to rescue and rehabilitate animals from the Texas Gulf Coast. And our first trip to the Amos Rehabilitation Keep is going to introduce you to this animal. This is Phyllis. And she is a Hawksbill sea turtle. So come, let's swim on the wild side of Hawksbill sea turtles. Hi guys, welcome to the wild side. Clay here, and I'm with our guest this week, Phyllis, a Hawksbill sea turtle. Now these animals can grow up to 200 pounds, and they're one of the five different species of sea turtle that call the Texas Gulf Coast home. Now Phyllis is currently residing at the Amos Rehabilitation Keep for very obvious reasons. She's missing that front right flipper. Presumably she could have lost that in entanglement with fishing line, she could have lost that at the hands or jaws of a predator, or she could have lost that in some other catastrophic, tragic injury like a boat strike or things of that sort. But it doesn't matter, the injury. When they come here to the Amos Rehabilitation Keep, they're given a second chance at life. And currently, Phyllis is in this deeper tank, this deeper pool, to see if she can check all the boxes and get out there ready for release. Now, once Phyllis becomes a wild Hawksbill sea turtle, she's going to do all the Hawksbill sea turtle things. She's going to look for food. Now, this animal specializes in munching on harder food items, sponges, coral, things of that nature. But Hawksbills are very opportunistic. I mean, so am I. They love to eat fish, they'll eat jellyfish, they'll graze on seagrass, and when they're younger, they'll be a part of those big sargassum blooms. Many of you might call it seaweed when you come to the beach, but it's very, very nutrient rich and very important for sea turtle hatchlings. Now, we're currently filming this in the summer of 2021, and it's hot down here on the Texas Gulf Coast. But this is the time where these animals would come in and lay their eggs. Once those eggs hatch, the babies then move from the nesting site down to the water's edge. And as they're moving down to the water's edge, they're actually creating the first boop on their internal map. You see, the Hawksbill sea turtle, and all sea turtles might have a brain only the size of your thumb, the tip of your thumb. However, they are able to navigate the world's oceans and their migration routes through this amazing sixth sense, this amazing ability to sense the Earth's magnetic fields. And they can come back to the exact same beach that they hatched out in, but it takes a while. You see, Phyllis and her other sea turtle cousins are going to be going through what's called the lost years. After a baby hatches, researchers and scientists really don't know a lot about their life. It takes 25 years on average for these animals to become mature enough to return back to that beach and lay their eggs for the first time, mature enough to even breed. But once they do, they come up on land, they dig a big nest with those flippers, and even though Phyllis is missing a flipper, she'll still be able to dig one world of a nest. And then she uses her back flippers to kick out the rest of the sand, she'll lay her eggs in there, cover them up, and then go offshore, off the coast, for a couple weeks. Then she can even come back in and do another clutch, lay more eggs, then cover them up. But those babies, they have a lot ahead of them. Hawksbill sea turtles and all sea turtles, over 90% of the babies are killed before they reach maturity due to predation, human impacts, currents, or just life in general. So the 10% of the turtles that reach that adulthood then return to these same Texas beaches to lay their eggs. Now, hawksbills are really, really unique animals, and like all sea turtles, are protected under the Endangered Species Act. But the hawksbill was initially impacted the most by conservation needs. You see, that beautiful shell there? Well, because it has such ornate edges, the hawksbill was hunted very heavily for sea turtle jewelry. Now, some people may also eat the meat, But the sea turtle jewelry of the shell and of the face there was what really did the Hawksbill sea turtle numbers in. But thanks to organizations like the Amos Rehabilitation Keep, the University of Texas Marine Science Institute, right here in Port Aransas, these animals' numbers are on the incline. And they're able to protect the nesting sites. They're able to research the species. They're able to tell us, the public, how to interact with our beaches more effectively and more turtle safe. Now, the Hawksbill sea turtle and all sea turtles could use your help. Reduce what you use. If you have plastic bags, switch them to canvas bags. You got plastic straws, switch them to stainless steel or bamboo straws. These animals could use less pollution put into their waterways each and every year. If we do that, we may be able to help the Hawksbill and all other species of sea turtle all around the world. Folks, this is my first trip to the Amos Rehabilitation Keep, but I promise it will not be the last. Tune in to future episodes of The Wild Side, where we talk about their shoreline birds, their birds of prey, and yeah, more sea turtles. In fact, we may even go on a sea turtle patrol, patrolling the beaches for nests and helping to keep the sea turtles safe right here in Texas. Until next time, everyone, stay wild, conservation rules, and we'll see you next week when we highlight yet another of your favorite species. Let's just hope your sixth sense for the world's magnetism is good enough to help you find your way right back here to The Wild Side on YouTube. Until then, bye everybody.